In this video, we will discuss how to consume reusable components from Razor class library. For this, first step, create a Razor class library project containing a Razor UI or component, for example, component 1. Second step, call a test API, namely JSON Placeholder API in the component 1 above and display some test data on it. After this step, the component 1 is ready to reference it by a Blazor WebAssembly app. In the third step, create a new Blazor WebAssembly project and reference the Razor class library project above. Finally, we can consume the component 1 above in the Blazor WebAssembly project. Now, let's start it. Create new project. Razor class library. Select this. With this selection, next. With this settings, click next. Now, we are ready to create the Razor class library. Create. Now, we have created a Razor class library. Inside this project, we have webroot folder, import Razor, and the component 1 Razor, and the example interrupts. Let's see the component 1. This is the component 1 created by default. First, we need to complete this component, namely we are going to display some data on this component. And then in the second step, we are going to call this component, namely we are going to consume this component on a Blazor WebAssembly application. For this, I need to install some NuGet packages. Let's install HTTP. Okay, now we have installed system.net.http. Therefore, we can use HTTP client inside this component or inside this project. Now, let's write the C# code portion of this component. In this component, we are going to display some test data. Namely, display some data from JSON Placeholder API. First, let's see the data in the JSON Placeholder API. This is the JSON Placeholder API. There are some test data. We can display it in the component. For example, let's display this user data set. This is the user data set we are going to display in the component. There are 10 users in this data set. This is the first user. This is the second user. We are going to display these users in the component. We don't display all data, but we display some selected elements inside this JSON object. We are going to display ID, name, username, email, and phone and website. Only selected elements, namely these selected elements. Therefore, we need to create a class. In the JSON Placeholder API, the user's dataset is an array. Therefore, we need to create an array. this data set is an array. Inside this array, there are multiple JSON objects. Therefore, we need to create an array here. Now we are going to get data from JSON Placeholder API by using HTTP client. Therefore, we need to put here JSON Placeholder's URL. Copy this URL. Paste it here. Clear this. Now save this. Now we have completed the C# portion of this component. In the next step, we are going to display this user data in this component. Therefore, we need some HTML code. Save it. We have completed the component. Namely, we have completed the component inside the Razor class library. Now we are ready to use this component in the Blazor WebAssembly app. Before consume this component, let's explain this. First, we completed the C# code portion of this component. Here we have created a user class. The properties of this class are corresponding to the elements in the JSON placeholder API. Namely, in the JSON placeholder, we have a user dataset. Inside that dataset, we have 10 users. Therefore, first we create a class corresponding to the elements inside the JSON placeholder's dataset. Because the data set inside the JSON placeholder is an array, therefore we created one users array. Then we created an initialized async method. Inside this method, we get data from the JSON placeholder by using the HTTP client. Now, inside this array, we have all users data. In the next step, we are going to display this data in the component. If the user is null, at the time, we will display this message, loading. If this is not null, we display that data in the HTML table. This is the HTML table to display the user's data set. This is the header portion of the table. Here we have six columns, namely ID, name, username, email, phone, and the website. Then in the table body, we have corresponding data. Because the user is an array, therefore we have used for each here and created all rows corresponding to the columns. Then in the table footer portion, let the credit to the data source. In the href, we have the URL of the JSON placeholder API. Now, this component one, namely a component inside the Razor class library, has been completed. And we are ready to use this component in Blazor WebAssembly apps. Namely, we are ready to consume this component in a Blazor WebAssembly application. In the next step, we are going to create a Blazor WebAssembly app project, and inside the project, we are going to call this component. Now, let's do that. First, we need to create a Blazor WebAssembly app. Blazor WebAssembly app. With this selection, next. Consume component from Razor class library. Create. Okay. Now, we have created a Blazor WebAssembly apps, namely consume component from Razor class library. In the first step, we need to reference the Razor class library. Therefore, okay. Now we can use the component from the Razor class library inside this consume component from Razor class library project. First, I need to create a test component. In the next step, I am going to call that component. First, I need to import the class library project. We have referenced the Razor class library project. Therefore, in the first step, before use it, I need to import it. Namely, I have imported here, Razor class library. Now, I am ready to use the component one. The component name is component one. Therefore, I added the route template, then I imported the Razor class library. In the second step, I call it the component one because this component one is already completed inside the Razor class library. Therefore, after I import Razor class library, I can use the component. Hopefully it will work. Now the test Razor component has been completed. In the next step, I am going to call this component in the side navigation bar of this application because we have a side navigation bar here. Therefore, I just copy this. Here, I just call the test component. Test, and then this is the label. Razor class library test. Save this. Now we are ready to run this application. It's building. Application is running. We just created this navigation menu. And if I click this menu, hopefully the users will display here. Okay, it works. Actually, this content inside this red line is coming from the Razor class library. First, we created a class library project. Inside the class library project, we created a component. Then, inside that component, we call it JSON's placeholder API, and we get some users' data and display it by using HTML table. Then, after complete that Razor class library, we referenced the Razor class library inside the Blazor WebAssembly app, and we created the test component inside the consumer application, and then we use it, we consume it, the component one from the Razor class library. This is the result. Thank you for your watching. Please subscribe.